take that risk.
He may not make it up from that. Now he's going to get up.
No,
rolls back.
The fight's over.
Big trouble. Big trouble. Knockout victory for Bailey. Tiltation. Here's the uppercut. Boom. You take that uppercut from an authoritative puncher like Bailey, and good luck on the getting up. That was sensational. Here's another look.
One of the best punches that I've saw ever. One of my favorite combinations is an uppercut underneath a jab. But those punches were there for both guys to land early, but they were just too reluctant and too cautious to let the punches go. That was a great, great knockout right there. I mean, I was really surprised.
いや、もう今からでもチャンスあると思いますね。はい。この左フックのタイミングと威力というのはこの階級ですが。いや、パンチありますね。やっぱり本当に軽量級とは思えないパワーがありますね。はい。で、なんか今日の相手はあの小さいサイズだったんです。
Tempo and pace.
A little bit wild.
The left hand very wide for Spilka, and he was hit with the right. Now he had taken right hands before in this fight and not been hurt, but that one was different because he was coming in and he was.
That time by holding Holyfield.
Right hand stuns Douglas. Caught him going in. He is not going to get up. There goes the heavyweight championship of the world.
Mills Lane with the count.
Holyfield has been. Heavyweight championship of the world. Let's take a look at that. Look at that uppercut. That's what he wanted to land. The right hand, solid. He's already going down. The left hook misses, but you only needed that right hand. A picture perfect right hand that Holyfield had practiced in case the uppercut would come in and miss. He landed exactly what he practiced. Let's watch it again. Comes the right hand, misses. He's trying Douglas for the first time. There's the uppercut. And the right hand over the uppercut. Out he goes. And he was down on the way down.
Now gets his feet back and tries to roar back to Vail Pacquiao with the right hand.
Oh! That's another knockdown.
He's not getting up, Jim.
Will he get up?
He's not getting up, Jim. He's not getting up.
No, he's been knocked out. A sensational right hand knockdown.
Yeah, right. You see that?
Pacquiao missed the right hand.
He knew he was coming. He just caught his rhythm because that's what has caused. So that's the shot, bam, right on the button that the weightlifting definitely will help you with.
That's the hardest and most dramatic shot we've seen in the sport since Sergio Martinez knocked out Paul Williams on November 20, 2010 in Atlantic City.
Brenda. He's been stride for stride throughout
his career. Check left hook. A check left hook went right into it. You never saw it.
What a free answer
down
the stretch.
Here you see the check left hook. As he was coming in, he caught him with the left hook, which he's been hitting with quite often tonight. That punch and the right-hand lead have been very consistent.
Patton going headfirst into the ring post, which certainly didn't help.
Champion non-pro.
All right. Okay. It was a clean left hook. Did you, I mean, you sparred with him years ago. We know that it didn't mean anything. Were you surprised that he went so fast?
Well, no, I knew if I catch someone clean, they'll go regardless who they are. Mm-hmm. But you know, when the referee he hit him with a shot, it looked like he was able to get up, but I guess the referee called what he saw because I didn't think he was hurt that bad, but I know I hit him with a clean shot.
Speculate for me. How long would it have taken you to get him?
There's the jab by Nonito Donaire at working well.
Oh, my. Oh, look out, D'Artagnan down for the first time. Struggling to get to his feet. In terrible shape. It's all over. It's all over. Nonito Donaire has pulled.
Earlier, Donaire had started to land the counter left hand, and here it would come in dramatic fashion. Again, lunging in D'Artagnan as he has, not concerned about defense.
Oh, my God! Face first!
takedown. This came from a tremendous uppercut on the inside by perfect time to throw.
See, this is, we don't have the up top view now, but this one makes it amazing. Look at his roll. He rolls on this right hand, blocks the punch with the same hand, and comes with the uppercut. I actually thought he partially took the right hand at first. He actually didn't take the right hand at all. He actually blocks the punch with the same hand as he's rolling, holds his ground, because your instinct is actually to pick up your feet and leave the pocket. I want to just specify how difficult that is to do. Holds his ground planted, blocks the shot, and uppercuts with the same hand.
Yeah, there because of the style of the opponent or whatever.
Shane Mosley learned that last Saturday night. Yeah. Again, once again, third knockdown of the night.
Who never saw it. Roy was just getting in a mode of having a good time at this stage right here. And as I was saying earlier, this guy was surviving because he wasn't that aggressive. And once he started coming in and committed himself, Roy just took advantage of him, caught him with a nice counter punch.
Well, Roy found the trick for knocking him out. He put his hands behind his back.
He said, come on. You can't get any better than this.